Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. In the previous chapter, we saw how algebra can be used to solve various types of percentage problems, including percentage change and profit and loss. In this chapter, we will see how to solve problems involving mixtures of solutions of different concentrations. But what exactly is a solution? And what does it mean to say that a solution has a particular concentration? A solution is a mixture of one substance called the solute dissolved in another substance called the solvent. The strength or concentration of a solution is often specified as the percentage volume of the solution, which is made up of solute. This is called the volume percent concentration. Volume percent is usually used to specify concentration when the solution is made by mixing two liquids. For example, in a solution of antifreeze in water, the solute is antifreeze and the solvent is water. So a 25 volume percent solution of antifreeze is made up of 1/4 volume of pure antifreeze and 3/4 volume of water. The volume percent concentration of a solution is calculated by dividing the volume of solute by the total volume of the solution and then multiplying this fraction by 100 to get a percentage. For example, if the volume of solute is 80 milliliters and the total volume of the solution made up of solvent plus solute is 800 milliliters, then the fraction of the solution which is solute is 80 over 800, or 1/10. Multiplying this fraction times 100, we get a volume percent concentration of solute of 10%. Given this relationship between the volume percent concentration, the volume of solute, and the volume of the solution, we can calculate any one of these three quantities if we know the values of the other two. Now, let's say that we have two flasks of antifreeze solution. One solution contains 10% antifreeze, and the other contains 50% antifreeze. If we mix 60 milliliters of the 10% solution with 20 milliliters of the 50% solution, what will be the percentage of antifreeze in the mixture? Let's start by creating a table which shows the volume of each solution and the volume of pure antifreeze solute contained in each solution. We know that the volume of the 10% solution is 60 milliliters and the volume of the 50% solution is 20 milliliters. Since the volume of pure antifreeze in the 10% solution was 10% of 60 milliliters, then the volume of antifreeze in that solution was 0.1 times 60, or 6 milliliters. Likewise, the volume of pure antifreeze in the 50% solution was 50% of 20 milliliters, or 0.5 times 20, or 10 milliliters. Now we can calculate the volume percent of antifreeze in the mixture of the two solutions by using our formula. The volume of pure antifreeze solute in the mixture is 6 milliliters plus 10 milliliters, or 16 milliliters. And the volume of the mixture of the two solutions is 60 milliliters plus 20 milliliters, or 80 milliliters. So the fraction of solution which is antifreeze is 16 divided by 80, or 0.2. Multiplying this fraction by 100, we get a volume percent concentration of 20%. So the percentage of antifreeze in the mixture is 20%. In In our next example, we will see how using algebra, it is possible to produce a mixture of a desired concentration by combining calculated quantities of two mixtures with different concentrations. A.V. Geekman has borrowed a leaf blower to perform some yard work. The blower runs on fuel, which is a mixture of gasoline and oil, where 5% of the mixture is oil. Unfortunately, AV's fuel can is empty, and there are no other containers of gasoline or oil available. However, there are two fuel barrels nearby which contain mixtures of gasoline and oil. The fuel in one barrel contains 12% oil, and the fuel in the other contains 2% oil. But since the blower requires a 5% oil mixture, the oil in one barrel is too concentrated, and the oil in the other is too diluted. AV wonders if fuel from the two barrels could be combined in some way to create a 5% oil mixture. Fortunately, using algebra, it is possible to calculate the amount of fuel to mix from each barrel in order to fill his 10-quart can with fuel containing 5% oil. We will start by creating a table which shows the quantity of fuel to take from each barrel and the amount of oil contained in each of these quantities of fuel. If we let X represent the volume of fuel to take from the 12% barrel, then the amount of fuel to take from the 2% barrel must be 10 minus X, since the two volumes must total 10 quarts. The amount of oil contained in the fuel from the 12% barrel will be 12% of X, or 0.12X. Likewise, the amount of oil contained in the fuel from the 2% barrel will be 2% of 10 minus X, or 0.02 times 10 minus X. So for any particular value of X, the top two expressions in our table tell us the volume of fuel to mix from each barrel, and the bottom two expressions tell us the volume of oil which will be present in those volumes of fuel. We can now use our equation for volume percent concentration to calculate the value of X. The solution in this equation is the fuel mixture of gasoline and oil we wish to create, and the solute is the oil which is dissolved in the gasoline. We know that the volume percent concentration of oil in the mixture we wish to create must be 5%. And the total volume of this mixture, or in other words, this solution, must be 10 quarts. The volume of solute is the total volume of oil in the mixture. In other words, the volume of oil from the 12% barrel plus the volume of oil from the 2% barrel. We now have an equation which we can solve to find the value of X. Since we are solving for X, we want to rearrange this equation so that the X is alone on the left side. Let's start by swapping the two sides of the equation. Multiplying the fraction by 100 is the same as multiplying its numerator by 100. Since 100 is 10 times 10, we can cancel one of the 10s in the numerator and the 10 in the denominator, leaving just the remaining terms in the numerator. Now, using the distributive property, we distribute the 0.02 multiplier to the two terms in parentheses. We can then eliminate the inner parentheses. Completing the multiplication in the middle term, 0.02 times 10 is 0.2. And combining like terms in the parentheses, 0.12x minus 0.02x is 0.1x. We can then distribute the 10 to the two terms in the remaining parentheses and eliminate the remaining set of parentheses. Completing the multiplication in the first term, 10 times 0.1x is 1x, or just x. And in the second term, 10 times 0.2 is 2. Subtracting 2 from both sides of the equation allows us to cancel the positive and negative 2s on the left, leaving us with the equation x equals 5 minus 2, or x equals 3. We can now substitute this value for x into our table to find the quantity of fuel to take from each barrel. We see that the quantity to take from the 12% barrel is 3 quarts, and the quantity to take from the 2% barrel is 10 minus 3, or 7 quarts. So by using algebra to calculate the quantities of the two fuel mixtures to combine, AV can complete his yard work. In this lecture, we have seen how to solve problems involving mixtures of solutions of different concentrations. In the next lecture, we will see how to solve problems involving other types of mixtures.